Vision Group environmental journalists, including Adrian Bwanika from Bukedde Television and Gerald Tenua from the New Vision newspaper, have been recognized by the Uganda Biodiversity Fund, the UBF, for their outstanding environmental reporting. The two, together with Nation Media's Tony Abet and Julius Amanyisa, were recognized for their informative environmental reporting, which has had a great impact on Uganda's biodiversity conservation landscape.
So congratulations, Adrian. I think the stories of Bukedde on destruction of wetlands, depletion of natural forests, very much appreciated. And you could see that everybody was attentive. So congratulations once again. Continue writing, I even write more. Thank you. Let's give him another applause.
Adrian Bwanika was the winner after he garnered a total of 2,097 votes, beating his closest competitor, Zadok Amanyisa, who got 1,563 votes. Abet clinched the third position with 250, while Vision's Tenua came fourth with 91 votes.
I'm very much excited to be the top conservation journalist of the year 2022. It's been a milestone, and I will have to credit a lot of people who are behind this victory, because it's not mine alone. One, I would love to credit the awarding body, who is the UBF, for this initiative, which seems to be energizing us to work more, to be part of the conservation of our environment in this country. This is very, very much encouraging. But I also want to credit the nominators, the voters, and with all people who have done quite a lot to ensure I emerge the winner of this year's award.
Apofia Atkunda, the UBF's executive director, said that the awards sought to reward outstanding journalists in the environmental sphere that have excelled in reporting about climate change in both print and electronic media. The organization is now putting emphasis on biodiversity sustainability.
Developing projects that are like that, that are not going to be destructive, but are going to earn us money. We are also looking at the area of human-wildlife conflict, because when people are in conflict with wildlife, they tend to go negative. They tend to want to kill it, to eliminate it. And yet you can work with biodiversity and earn money out of it. So we are also focusing in that area for the next 5 years.
In his address, Dr. Kalist Tindimugaya, the Director of Water Resource Management, said that the lack of sufficient funding for biodiversity is not only in Uganda, but rather across the globe.
Institutions putting in place structures, governance structures, procedures, it's not easy. And I think, as has been mentioned, you have done the establishment, now you are ready to fry. And I'm sure that the next strategic plan will take you to that level where you will achieve the overall objectives. I also would like to thank the US government and the EU for the support they have provided the Uganda Biodiversity Fund. Again, you almost achieved your target.
According to surveys, Uganda is doing exceptionally well in biodiversity, with the occurrence of 18,783 species. Although the country covers just 241,551 kilometers squared and accounts for only 0.18% of the world's terrestrial and freshwater surface, Uganda harbors 4.6% of the dragonflies, 6.8% of the butterflies, 7.5% of the mammals, and 10.2% of the bird species globally recognized.